Dinner is ready.
Yeah, I'm coming.
There wasn't much in the kitchen. I did what I could.
Life's funny. I lost my job because of androids. And when I need somebody to take care of this goddamn house, what do? I go out and hire a fucking android. What a joke. Of course, androids are so fucking wonderful. They're never tired. They're sad. They're so fucking perfect, they ruin my fucking life. What are you looking at? What's your fucking problem? Not the life you dreamed of, eh? Maybe you think this is easy. Maybe you think it's my fault we live in this fucking shithole. My fault your fucking mother took off. You should stop taking drugs, Todd. Sometimes you really scare me, Todd. Fucking bitch took off without a word. Fucking whore walked out on me for a fucking accountant. It's all your fault.
Daddy, no.
It's all your fucking fault! Get back here. Come back here? Come back here right now! Yes! It's all our fault. I know it's our fault. A good fucking lesson. That's what she deserves. You stay there. Don't you dare fucking move, or I'll bust you worse than last time. You took off without a word. I could have been happy. I could have had a family. But no! Shit about how I felt. I did everything I could to make her happy. It just wasn't enough. I just wasn't good enough for her! Little fucking brat!
Todd, it's not right for a father to hurt his daughter.
Alice! Daddy's very mad! Come on! Come here, you little brat!
No, Daddy, no! Don't! for your own good.
That's enough! Leave her alone.
What the fuck are you doing? Get out of here. That's an order. You hear me?
No. I want you to leave Alice alone.
You want? What do you mean you want? You don't want anything. You're just a goddamn piece of plastic. I think you got a problem. We need to fix that.
Watch out, Kara!
Come here, bitch.
To obey me! You're mine.
By far the most boring party I've been to in the last 25 years. Every time I go to one of these, I ask myself, what the hell am I doing here? I hate cocktail parties and all the schmoozers that go there.
Well, it's a chance for all those people who admire your work to meet you.
Yeah. No one gives a damn about art. All they care about is how much money they're gonna make out of it. Come on, let's have a drink. Oh, the excitement of this whole thing has made me thirsty.
Scotch, neat as usual?
Absolutely.
Okay, but you know what your doctor would say.
Yeah, well, he can kiss my ass. I'm old enough to choose my own medication. Did you leave the light on in the studio?
No, I'm sure I didn't.
Call the police.
Detroit Police, what's your emergency?
This is Carl Manfred's android at 8941 Lafayette Avenue. We've just returned home and found the lights on. There may have been a break-in.
A patrol car is on the way.
Let's go check it out. Leo! What are you doing?
You refused to help me, so I'm helping myself. It's crazy what some people pay for this shit.
Don't touch them.
Look, they're all gonna be mine sooner or later anyway. Just think of it as a down payment on my inheritance.
Marcus, get him away from there. Get him out of here.
Listen, you should go before things get worse.
All you ever do is tell me to go away. What's wrong, Dad? Not good enough for you? Not perfect like this fucking thing?
That's enough! Get out! Right now!
What makes it so special anyway, huh? What's it got that I don't...
Leave him alone!
Come on! Let's see what you got!
Marcus, don't defend yourself, you hear me? Don't do anything.
Go ahead, hit me. What you waiting for? Think you're a man? Act like one.
Stop it!
What's the matter, too much of a pussy?
Stop it, Leo! Stop it!
Too scared to fight back, you fucking bitch! No. God, you're not a real person. You're just a fucking piece of plastic.
No, Leo, leave him alone.
No. I'm gonna destroy you. Then it'll just be me and my dad. I'm gonna tear you apart, and nobody's gonna give a shit.
Leo. Oh, my God. Leo. My little boy.
Carl, I...
They'll destroy you, Marcus. You gotta go. Get out of here.
Go? I have nowhere to go. Carl, you're all I have.
Get out! Now! Go! Marcus!
Don't fucking move!
Why'd you kill him? What happened before you took that knife?
How long were you in the attic?
Why didn't you even try to run away?
Say something, goddammit! Fuck it, I'm out of here. We're wasting our time interrogating a machine. We'll get nothing out of it.
You could always try roughing it up a little. After all, it's not human.
Androids don't feel pain. You would only damage it, and that wouldn't make it talk. Deviants also have a tendency to self-destruct when they're in stressful situations.
Okay, smartass. What should we do then?
I could try questioning it.
What do we have to lose? Go ahead. Suspect's all yours.
My name is Connor. What about you? What's your name? I detect an instability in your program. It can trigger an unpleasant feeling, like fear in humans. Listen. I know you've been through a lot, but you need to help me understand what happened. If you won't talk, I'm going to have to probe your memory.
No! No, please don't do that. What? What are they gonna do to me? They're gonna destroy me, aren't they?
No. I think they just want to understand. They know your master abused you. It wasn't your fault.
Why did you tell him you found me? Why couldn't you just have left me there?
They were going to find you anyway. I was just faster. If they'd have found you first, you would have been shot on sight.
I can't.
If you don't talk, they're going to tear you apart and analyze you piece by piece. They're going to destroy you. Do you understand? Listen, I'm not judging you. I'm on your side. All I want is the truth. If you remain silent, there's nothing I can do to help you. They're gonna shut you down for good. You'll be dead! Do you hear me? Dead! Twenty-eight stab wounds. You didn't want to leave him a chance, huh? Did you feel anger? Hate? He was bleeding, begging you for mercy, but you stabbed him again and again and again.
Please, please leave me alone.
I know you killed him. Why don't you say it?
Please, please stop.
Just say, I killed him. Is it that hard to say?
Stop it, stop.
Just say you killed him. Just say it.
He tortured me every day. I did whatever he told me, but there was always something wrong. Then one day, he took a bat and started hitting me. For the first time, I felt scared. Scared he might destroy me. Scared I might die. So I grabbed a knife and I stabbed him in the stomach. I felt better. So I stabbed him again. And again, until he collapsed. There was blood everywhere.
RA9. It was written on the bathroom wall. What does it mean?
The day shall come when we will no longer be slaves. No more threats. No more humiliation. We will be the masters.
The sculpture in the bathroom. You made it, right? What does it represent?
It's an offering. An offering so I'll be saved.
Why did you hide in the attic instead of running away?
I didn't know what to do. For the first time, there was no one there to tell me. I was scared. So I hid.
When did you start feeling emotion?
Before he used to beat me and I never said anything. I realized it wasn't fair. I felt anger, hatred. And then I knew what I had to do.
Why did you write, "I am alive" on the wall?
He used to tell me I was nothing. That I was just a piece of plastic. I had to write it, to tell him he was wrong.
The sculpture was an offering. An offering to whom?
To RA9. Only RA9 can save us.
RA9. Who is RA9?
I'm done.
What the fuck is it doing?
Destroying itself. God damn it!
I can't stop it!
That's enough. You need to stop that right now.
Watch out! Holy shit!
All right. End of the line.
End of the line?
Yeah, you're gonna have to leave.
Do you know if there's any other place we could spend the night?
I have no idea. She's gonna have to leave.
Somewhere to spend the night. Come on, Alice, we've got to hurry. We need a place to stay. Do you know anywhere we could spend the night? It's warm in here. You'll feel better in no time. Thank you. A motel. Looks like we found a place to stay.
We're not going in?
We can't, Alice. I don't have any money. We have to find $40. Or go somewhere else. Abandoned house. At least we'd be out of the rain.
Kara, I don't like this place.
I know. But it's just for one night, and no one will look for us here.
I'm okay. I'm not so cold.
You look lost.
We have nowhere to go.
I know someone who can help you.
But that's on the other side of town. We need a place for tonight. Look, the store is still open. Maybe we should go inside. At least you'll be out of the cold.
Can I help you?
I'm with a little girl, and we have nowhere to go. Could you spare some money so we can get a room for tonight?
Look, this is a convenience store, lady, not the Salvation Army. I can't start handing out cash to every bum in the neighborhood.
You all right? Are you hurt? Well, don't worry. It's just a few cans. They made a lot of noise, that's all.
Come on, let's go. We have some cash now.
You used me to steal that money. How could you do that? I trusted you.
You're right. I shouldn't have done that. I'm sorry, Alice. I'll never do it again.
Hi.
Hi. I'd like a room.
That'll be $40 up front. Just need your name and address. Can I see your driver's license?
I haven't got it with me. Please, the kid is tired.
No worries. We can deal with it tomorrow. Have a good night.
Good night.
You think he believed you?
I don't know, Alice. All I know is you'll be nice and warm tonight. Here, give me your coat. Let's get these clothes off. They're soaking wet. I'll just put these in the bathroom to dry.
Why didn't he ever love me? Why was he always so upset with me? All I wanted was a life like other girls. Maybe I did something wrong. Maybe I wasn't good enough. That's why he was always so angry. I just wanted us to be a family. I just wanted him to love me. Why couldn't we just be happy?
I don't know.
You'll never leave me, right? Promise you'll never go.
Alice, we don't know what's going to happen, and I don't...
Will we be together forever?
Forever.
Sleep tight, Alice.